Good morning, students. Today we will start with the next exercise of your lesson 9, unitary method. So in the last lecture I told you what is unitary method. So what is unitary method? In the unitary method is a technique in which we first find about one unit and then we find about required number of units. Yes. So in unitary method, first we find about one unit, because unit means one. So first we find about one unit and then we find about required number of units. Now I told you in unitary method we come across two types of variations. One is direct variation and the second is indirect variation. So we can also call it direct proportion or inverse proportion, indirect proportion, so whatever. So direct variation, indirect variation or inverse proportion. So in the last lecture we did the direct proportion. So let me revise what was that. In the direct proportion, I explained you with the example. Suppose you have to buy some pens. Suppose you are going to buy 5 pens and the cost of 5 pens is 10 rupees. Okay. Now if you want 10 pens, so what will happen? So if the number of pens has increased, their cost also will increase. Now in order to find about 10 pens, first I will find the cost of 1 pen. So 1 pen ka cost kitna hoga? The number of pens is decreased, the cost also will decrease. So 5 pens ka cost 10 rupees. So 1 pen ka cost will be, I will divide, 10 divided by 5 is 2 rupees. It means the cost will be 2 rupees. And if I want to buy 10 pens, then because the cost of 1 pen is 2 rupees, the cost of 10 pens will be 10 multiplied by 2, 20 rupees. So in this, as I can see, if the number of pens has decreased, the cost also has decreased. If the number of pens have increased, the cost also has increased. So this was direct variation, in which the increase in one causes the increase in other. Sorry, the decrease in one causes the decrease in other, and the increase in one causes the increase in other. So this was direct variation. Now in this lecture we will study about the indirect variation, or I said it's called inverse proportion. Inverse proportion or indirect variation. So let me take one example. Suppose I say there are number of men, okay, and the number of days it takes. So I have two things. One is number of men and number of days. Suppose I say that 8 men are there who can complete some work. कोई भी काम दिया है, suppose they have to build a wall, एक दीवार बनानी है, so 8 men are there and they can complete the work in 3 days. Okay, so 8 people can complete or make a wall, build a wall in 3 days. Suppose I have only 4 men now, सिर्फ 4 लोग हैं. In place of 8 people, now I have 4 men. Now just think. Now if I have less people, will they take less days to complete the work? Agar kam log hain, to wo kam din mein kaam pura karenge? No, it cannot be. If the number of men have decreased, it means they will take more days to complete the work. They will take more days. So I am having less men and they will take more days. So what happened? So here the value has decreased, but the number of days will increase. So less men, they will take more days. Ek kam ho raha hai aur ek badh raha hai. While this is called inverse proportion, jisme ek कम हो रहा है तो दूसरे का वैल्यू ज़्यादा हो रहा है. वाइल इन डायरेक्ट प्रपोर्शन व्हाट डिड वी सी दैट इफ वन यूनिट वन वैल्यू वॉज इंक्रीजिंग द अदर ऑल्सो वॉज इंक्रीजिंग. ठीक है, सो नाउ लेट मी डू दिस. Now I have understood that if the number of people have decreased, they will take more days. Okay, so now to apply the unitary method, in order to find about one man, first I will find about, in order to find about four men, first I will find about one man. So if one man only is there, it means he will take more days. And to find about more, what we do? We have to multiply this 8 into 3. It means they will take 20, one person will take 24 days. So did you see, as this is inverse proportion, as the number of men have decreased, the number of days will increase. And to find this, in order to find about one person, I have to multiply. While in direct proportion, what we were doing to find about one, we were dividing. But in inverse proportion, we have to multiply 8 into 3. So one person will take 24 days. Now I know that one man will take 24 days. Now if from one, then this number has been increased. Now if I have more people, I know that one person can complete in 24 days. Now if I have more people, four people, it means they will take less days. So in order to find about less, what I will do? Now I will divide this 24 days divide with 4, 4, 6, 24. So it means 4 people will take 6 days to complete the work. So as the number has decreased, the number of people have decreased, the number of days have increased. As the number of men have increased, the number of days have decreased. Now let's come to the first question of your exercise 9B. Now in the first question you will see that they are saying if 48 men can dig a trench in 14 days. So what are the two quantities given? One is the number of men and one is the number of days. So 48 people they are saying can do the work in 14 days. How long means how many days? So I have put the variable x over here. How long will 28 men take to dig a similar trench? Now first of all I have to decide whether this is indirect or direct. Now I see that if the number of men have decreased and they are digging some trench, koi gadda khod rahe hai, theek hai? So 48, first they were 48 people and they could dig the trench in 14 days, but now I have only 28 men, so number of men have decreased. So will they take more days or less days? Yes, they will take more time to complete the work. So this is decreased, but the number of days will increase. So one is decreasing, other is increasing. It means this is indirect proportion or inverse proportion. Okay, so now I will write them in the form of ratio. Now I know that this is inversely proportional. So 48 is to 28. How this ratio will be equal to this if I put this in the inverse form. So I will put this x front, I will reciprocate it. So x it's to 14 it will become. So then the two ratios will be equal if I write this in the inverse form. Now I can say 48 is to 28 is equal to, I can write also as proportional. 48 is to 28 is proportional to x is to 14. So the again product of extremes means 48 into 14 and 28 into x. Now you have to find x, it means 48 into 14 upon 28. 14 2s are 28 and 2 2s are 2 4s are 8. X is equal to 24. It means 28 people will take 24 days to complete the work. So the number of men have decreased and the number of days have increased. So decrease here and increase here. So this is indirect proportion. Now, if I come to the fifth question, look at the fifth question. They say a girl can finish a book in 25 days if she reads 18 pages of it every day. So the two things given in this are pages and the number of days. Now they say if she reads 18 pages in a day, she can complete the book in 25 days. But if how many days will she take? So I will put the variable x on the number of days. How many days will she take to finish it if she reads only 15 pages in a day? Okay, now if she decreases the number of pages, so will she take more time to complete the book or less time? Because she has decreased her reading, it means the time in which she will finish her work, finish reading the book, that will be increased. So this has decreased, but the number of days will increase. So what type of proportion is this? It is inverse proportion. Okay, now how I will put this? Now 18 is to 15. This ratio will be equal to this. How? If I put this in the inverse proportion, like x is to 25, I will write. So I will write the inverse of this. So I will write this 18 is to 15 will be equal to x is to 25. Now this equality sign I can change into the sign of proportionality, because two ratios are equal. When two ratios are equal, they are said to be in proportion. Now product of extremes, 18 into 25, and product of means is 15 into x. Now to take out the value of x, 18 into 25 upon 15. 5 is 25, 5 3 is 15, 3 6 is 18. So how much you get? 6 5 is 30. So if she reads 15 pages in a day, she will take 30 days to complete her book. So the number of pages is decreased and the number of days have increased. Now I will take the seventh question. In the seventh question, they say a bus covers a certain distance in 3 hours 20 minutes at an average speed of 45 kilometers per hour. So what are the two things given? Is one is speed in kilometers per hour and one is time taken. So they say that if the speed of the bus is 45 minutes, it takes 3 hours and 20 minutes to cover the distance. And if the speed of the bus is 36 kilometers per hour, how much time it will take? Now looking at the question, you can see if the speed of the bus has decreased, agar aap car pe bhi jaate ho, agar slow speed pe jaoge to kya hoga? You will take more time to cover the distance. Yes, so if the speed of the bus is decreased, so it means it will take more time to cover the distance. So less speed and more time. So what type of variation? Indirect. Now first of all, this 3 hours 20 minutes, I cannot work with two units. It means I have to convert this into a single unit. So 3 hours. Now in 1 hour, how many minutes are there? I have 60 minutes. So in 3 hours, how many minutes will be there? 60 multiplied by 3. So how many? 180 minutes plus 20 minutes more are there. So how much they become? 200 minutes. It means that the time is how many minutes? So I will take the time in minutes. So time in minutes, and it takes 200 minutes. If it goes at a speed of 45 kilometers per hour, it will take 200 minutes. But if the speed is decreased, it means it will take more time. So if I write this in this ratio, 45 is to 36, the ratio of this will be equal to the inverse of this. So x is to 200. So because both the ratios are equal, I can say that this ratio is proportional to this ratio. So product of extremes, 45 into 200 is equal to product of means 36 into x. So x will be 45 into 200 upon 36. 9 5s are 9 4s are 4 5s are. So how much time? 5 5s are 22, 50 minutes. So the bus will take 250 minutes if its speed is decreased. It will take more time. So 250 minutes it will. I take the 8th question. In the 8th question they say, at the beginning of a month a factory has enough material to make 240 tons of steel in a month. So they have taken the two quantities are steel, quantity of the steel and the number of days. Now they are saying in a factory there is material, raw material hota hai, kaccha material jisse wo steel banate hai. So they are saying the factory has a material for making steel, for making 240 tons of steel, and that material lasts for 30 days in a month. In a month means 30 days. Now you will say ki ma'am 31 days bhi hote hain, 28 days bhi hote hain, but we take, if we are not told whether it's a month of January or February or March, we take the number of days as 30 only. Okay, so they say they have material to, in a factory they have material to make 240 tons of steel, and that material would get finished in 30 days. Jo ye material hai steel banane ke liye, it will get finished in 30 days if you make 240 tons of steel. But now they say if 60 more tons of steel is to be made, agar mujhe 240 तो बन ही रहा है, उसमें 60 टन्स और बनाने हैं स्टील, तो फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज द मटेरियल विल लास्ट, फॉर जो जिस मटेरियल से स्टील बनाया जाता है वो कितने दिन में ख़त्म हो जाएगा. ना इफ़ आई हैव टू मेक मोर स्टील, इट मीन्स 300 टन्स आई हैव टू मेक, देन द मटेरियल विल फिनिश ऑफ इन लेस डेज. अगर मुझे ज़्यादा स्टील बनाना है तो वो जो मटेरियल जिसे मैं स्टील बना रही हूँ वो जल्दी ख़त्म हो जाएगा. फर्स्ट इट वॉज लास्टिंग फॉर 30 डेज, इफ़ आई वॉज टू मेक 240 टन्स इट वॉज लास्टिंग फॉर 30 डेज, दैट मटेरियल वॉज लास्टिंग फॉर 30 डेज. लेकिन अगर मुझे अब ज़्यादा स्टील बनाना है तो इट मीन्स वो जो मटेरियल है स्टील बनाने का वो जल्दी ख़त्म हो जाएगा. सो मोर स्टील and the material will be finished in less days. So more, less. So which type of variation? Indirect. So how I will put this in the proportional form? 240 is to 300. Now how this ratio is equal to this? Because I know that these are inverse proportion, in inverse variation. So I'll put this in inverse form. X is to 30. Now because both the ratios are equal, so I can use the sign of equality or proportionality. So product of extremes, 240 into 30 will be equal to the product of means, 300 into x. Now in order to find x, 240 into 30 upon 300, 00 gets cancelled, 3 tens are 30, 00 gets cancelled and you are left with 24. It means if I have to make more steel, the material will finish in 24 days. More steel I have to make, the material will finish early in 24 days. Now we come to the 9th question. In the 9th question they say a contractor employed 210 men to build a house in 60 days. So there is a contractor, he employed 210 men. So we have the two things in this, one is number of men and one is the number of days. He employed the 210 people for 60 days. Now they say after 12 days he was joined by 70 more men. So first he had employed 210 people, but after 12 days 70 more people came to join the work. So how many total people were there after 12 days? After 12 days they had 280 people. Now they say in how many days will the remaining work will be finished? Now the remaining work after means 210 people had worked for 12 days, whatever work was remaining, now that work was to be completed by 280 people instead of 210 people. So remaining work I have to find. So I will find out that this remaining work now was to be completed in how many days, because initially it was 60 days, but they worked for 12 days. So it means the remaining work was to be finished within 48 days. So I will take out the remaining days. I'll take out the remaining days to find out the remaining work. Okay, so remaining days are 48 days. So I will say that 210 people, the work which was they were to be were to finish in 48 days. Now because there are 280 people, how many days they will take? So I will take the remaining days to find out the remaining work. Okay, so now I know as the number of people have increased, first there were 210, now there are 280 people. So it means if the number of men have increased, it means the number of days will decrease. They will finish off the work in less days. So which variation is this? This is indirect variation. So I can write this as 210 is to 280. As how this ratio is equal to this, when I will inverse this, as this is indirect variation, x is to 48. Now product of extremes is equal to product of means. So when you find x, this both can be cancelled on the table of 7, 7 3s are, 7 4s are, now 4 1s are, 4 2s are, so what do you get? 12 3s are 36. So 280 people will complete the remaining work in 36 days. So more people and less time they will take. In the 10th question, now they say a military camp has provisions for 630 men to last for 25 days. So if there are 630 people, they have the food for 25 days. So how many men must be transferred to another camp so that the food now lasts for 30 days? Now they're asking you, how many men should I transfer to the other camp so that the food which was to finish in 25 days, now it should last for 30 days. So it means I have to decrease the number of people. Now first of all, what I will do is I will find out the number of men who can have this same food for 30 days. Okay, so I will find out how many people should be there so that my food lasts for 30 days. So as I know, I want the food to be finished for a longer time. So it means my number of men should be less. So less, more days, I want less number of men. So which variation is this? This is indirect variation. So when I will solve 630 is to x, that this ratio is equal to the inverse of this, so 30 is to 25. Now the product of extremes is equal to the product of means. Now to find x, 30 I will send to the other side, so 3 2s are, 3 1s are, so what you will get? 25 1s are is 25. 525. Now it means if I will have 525 people, they can finish, they can have the food for 30 days. It means they are asking you how many people should be shifted to the other camp. So it means if I shift from 630, first 630 people were there, now I want 525 people so that my food lasts for 30 days. It means I will I should transfer 105 people to the other camp. So this is the answer. Sir, they ask you how many people should be transferred to the other camp so that the food now lasts for 30 days. So I know that if I want my food to last for 30 days, there should be only 525 people. So instead of 630, I should have only 525 people. So how many people I will transfer to the other camp? 630 minus 525, 105 people I should transfer to the other camp. Now for the 11th question, they say a group of 120 men had provisions for 200 days. Now there are 120 people and they have food for 200 days. After 5 days, 30 men died due to an epidemic. So after 5 days, 30 men died. It means first there were 120 people. Now how many people are left since 30 people have died? Now 90 people are left. Now they are saying how long will the remaining food last? ठीक है, पहले जो 120 लोगों के लिए sufficient था, after 5 days, 5 दिन के बाद जो remaining food है, वो 90 लोगों के लिए for how many days it will last. Now they are asking about the remaining food, so I will take out the remaining days. Because after 5 days they are saying, so what will be the remaining days? The remaining days will be 195. So I can say that now the 120 people, the food which they were to finish in 195 days, the remaining days, now the remaining food will be finished by 90 people in how many days? Since 30 people have died, 90 people are left, now the remaining food will last for how many days if 90 people are there? And remaining food and remaining days I will take to find out the remaining food, about the remaining food. So again I can say that if the people have increased, it means the number of days will increase. So decrease and increase, so which variation? It means indirect variation. So 120 is to 90, as I will inverse this, x is to 195. So 120 into 195 is equal to x into 90. So x will be 120 into 195 upon 90. So 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 6 are 18, 3 5s are 15, 260. So it means if now 90 people are left, they will finish the remaining food in 260 days. Now we start the 12th question. In the 12th question they say 1200 soldiers in a fort had enough food for 28 days. So there are 28 soldiers in a fort. What is a fort? It's a killa. जिसको हम किला कहते हैं. So in a fort 1200 soldiers, they had food for 28 days. Now after 4 days, so again here they say after 4 days, some soldiers were transferred to another fort and thus the food lasted for 32 days. First 1200 soldiers had food for 28 days, but after 4 days some of the soldiers left the fort, and now because some of the soldiers had left, the soldiers had become less. Now the food was to be finished in 32 days, and they are asking you how many soldiers have left. They are asking you how many soldiers have left the fort. Okay, so now first of all, after 4 days, now the fort has enough food for how many days? After 4 days, first it had food for 28, now it had food for 24 days. So for the food which was to be finished by 1200 people in 24 days now, because after 4 days, now because some of the soldiers have left, now it will last for 32 days. Now what I will do is, first I will find out how many soldiers should be there so that the food should last for now 32 days. Now, because they have asked you how many soldiers have left, it means whatever number I will get over here, from I will subtract it from this, from initial soldiers, like 1200, may say, if I will subtract this number of soldiers, I will get 1200 minus 6, I will get the answer that how many soldiers have left the fort. Now, let's start. Now, the 1200 soldiers have the remaining food for remaining days, that are 24. Now, if the food is to last for 32 days, now how many soldiers should be there? Because the days are more, it means the number of soldiers should be less. So, it means indirect variation. Now, 1200 is to x as indirect variation it is. So how I will write this? I will inverse it. I will say 32 is to 24. Now product of extremes is equal to the product of means. Now x is equal to 1200 into 24 divided by 32. Now these two can be cancelled on the table of 8. 8 threes are and 8 fours are. Now 4 threes are 12. And now 900. Now what it means is x I had kept as the number of soldiers who will finish the food in 32 days. Now it means 900 soldiers, if 900 soldiers are there, they will finish the food in 32 days. So it means how many soldiers have left the fort? First we had 1200, now there are 900. So it means how many have been shifted to the other fort? 300 soldiers. And this only was the question. They had asked you how many soldiers have been transferred to another fort. So 300 soldiers have been transferred to the other fort.